Over its 64-year history, Pan Am built up an extensive medium and long-haul international network, operating the newest aircraft with a well-trained crew and excellent onboard service. Had it not met its end in 1991, how would the airline look today? Pan American World Airways, or Pan Am, was founded in 1927 and started with mail services between the United States and Cuba. In 1928, this expanded to passenger service and throughout the 1930s grew to several more Latin American destinations. This international expansion continued with the Boeing 314 Clipper flying boats operating luxurious and expensive long-distance services. Moving on, Pan Am was at the forefront of passenger jet travel as the launch customer for the Boeing 707. It even had a hand in designing the 747, serving 11 million passengers to 86 different countries in 1970. Unfortunately, Pan Am's glory days would not last forever, and deregulation of the US aviation industry in the late 70s brought increased competition. Additionally, the energy crisis during that same period brought rising fuel costs and additional pressure. The reputational damage from the bombing of a 747 over Scotland in 1988 was about the final straw, and the airline ceased operations in 1991. Had Pan Am been able to weather these problems, perhaps through financing or restructuring, it would likely have looked very different today. With the rise of other competition, perhaps the airline would have focused on its original strengths of serving Central and South America, likely from a base in Miami. It's also doubtful that its spacious seating and top-level service would have continued to the same extent it did in the 60s, although at the same time we would hope that top-end premium cabins would continue, especially with its long legacy of doing so. Pan Am was a pioneer in many areas, including new routes, the introduction of new aircraft, and some of the earliest loyalty and frequent flyer programs. It was even a founding member of IATA. Its close history with Boeing might have made it an early customer of both the 777 and 787, maybe even the 747-8, given its long history of jumbo jet operations. While its identity would have fit nicely with the A380, its American roots and relationship to Boeing may have prevented this. It operated before the rise of the global airline alliances, but if it was around then, it would likely have led the way in their formation. Perhaps Pan Am would have joined the first of the alliances, the Star Alliance, in 1997. A lot has happened in aviation since Pan Am ceased operations in 1991, and it's obviously hard to speculate how things would have looked today. We would imagine the carrier being somewhat of an American version of Emirates, but it's hard to know if market forces would have allowed this kind of airline to survive in the United States. We'd love to know how you would picture Pan Am operating today, its fleet, its routes, and its alliances. Let us know in the comments. Did you know that we publish over 175 stories every single week on simpleflying.com? Be sure to check the link in the description for more great stories just like this. Thanks for watching, and be sure to like and subscribe before you go.